Hey guys, the Ebby Monkey, and welcome back to Seed Sunday, the time of the week when I give you a brand new seed to come and enjoy and have fun with. And this week's seed is perfect for anyone who wants loot and awesome terrain. I'm not kidding, this seed is filled with awesome, awesome loot. A village, dungeon, and also a desert temple with a massive desert. What more do you want, guys? I'm giving you blood here. I'm giving you horses as well. On top of that, it's all horses. So let's just jump in and show you what this beautiful seed has to offer you out there. Offer you all. That's what I was trying to say. So this week's seed was born right here in this beautiful plains biome, right next to the desert and right next to savannah. Not only are you getting desert, you're getting savannah. Now, as always, at the coordinates in the top left-hand side of the screen, right up there. And the seed is in the top right-hand side of the screen, right up there. And of course, you can go and check the doobly-doop below and copy and paste it from the description. So if you want to get the seed, just go and copy and paste it. It's right down there. So as I said, you just born next to this beautiful desert. It is quite a large desert. I mean, I went through this thing for quite some time, and there is a savannah at the end of it. There's a savannah right there as well, and there is a village right behind me. Oh my god, village. And not only do you see a village, you've got 10 farms filled with carrots and potatoes and wheat and villages farming, and also a blacksmith. That is right, guys, a blacksmith right at spawn. What more do you want? So if you go in the blacksmith here, you'll find that you have yourself 4 iron ingots, another 4 iron ingots, and almost a full set of armor right there. Now you can make yourself a helmet with those 5 there, and then you can make a pickaxe with those. And if you want to obviously get yourself some wood, steal it from the villagers. They've got loads of it. See, their entire houses are made of it. Steal one of the logs and make yourself some wood. Easily done. Now of course you've got your villagers here to trade with as well. This blacksmith here wants you to give you some coal with an emerald, some emeralds for a helmet. Just got one from your chest, pretty much. I'm stealing all your stuff, dude. Sorry about that. You also got yourself some chickens and some horses. They are different things. I loaded the seed 3 times now. Once there were donkeys, once there were horses, once there were black horses, once there were brown horses. And yeah, they change from time to time. But you will get horses right at spawn. So if you want to get horses, then you can. Now, not only do you want to get horses, you might want to get yourself some horse armor and a saddle and stuff like that. Well, there are some around this place. There are dungeons dotted around this entire world. I found loads of them. But I'm only going to show you the ones that I found that I think are pretty good. So if you head over this direction, you will find yourself a desert temple. Now, in this desert temple, there is TNT, so be careful when you're going down, of course. If you go inside, I'm going to break these little bits here. There we go. And go on down. Get the platform, break it. In this chest here, you've got yourself a saddle. There you go. You can ride your horses and some rotten flesh. Not the greatest, but still some rotten flesh. In this one, you got yourself 2 diamonds. 2 freaking diamonds. And 3 rotten flesh. Not the greatest, but still, once again, pretty cool. In this one, you get another 3 diamonds. That is 5 diamonds in total. You can make yourself a sword now. A diamond sword. See? Diamond sword. And a diamond pickaxe. There you go. Get rid of your iron one. Make yourself a diamond pickaxe. You've got enough. And you've got some more iron as well as this book. Fire protection 3 and punch 1. It's just insane. You got yourself 5 bones there and 7 more flesh. And in this one, you got yourself 6 bones. Not the greatest, but still pretty damn cool. We break that. We don't need to because nothing underneath it. But I figured, why not? Let's just break it. Destroy it. Blow it up. Blow it all up. We go down here. We got ourselves some diorite and andesite and yeah, everything basically. Just some blocks. Nothing of interest. Nothing of interest at all. Now, there is a desert temple over this way as well. You can probably just see it right about now. There it is. There is a desert temple there. I'm not going to go and explore it. I will leave that up to you guys. There's not the greatest loot, I will admit. There is not the best loot in it. But if you're wanting some iron, you want some rotten flesh or whatnot, then go and check out that desert temple as well. It's just in this direction, in the minus X towards that direction. And you can get yourself another desert temple if you so wish. Now, if we get ourselves to minus 353, which is right about here. There we go. -353. And then Z is 136, which is just in this direction. 136 right there. And we fall, all the way down here. And dig our way down here. Keep going down. Oh, there we go. Quite close to surface, as you can see. Not that far down. I mean, we're starting at 51, and surface is at 64-ish. There, 65. So you can make yourself a spawner quite easily with this, and you can get yourself a load of zombies and loads of XP. Now, in this chest, it is lots of loot. I mean, not kidding. There is so much loot in this chest. We open it up and watch. Loot! So much of it. We get ourselves 3 buckets, 4 of gunpowder. You get ourselves 7 wheat, another saddle, so you can get yourself 2 horses now, some saddle armor, horse armor even, some string, a bit of bread, Four redstone, a music disc, cat, finally a disc that isn't, you know, the same, well, it's always the same as the other ones, but still, it's a one disc rather than 17, a name tag, and another enchantment book, and this time, you're getting something pretty cool, I'm not joking guys, pretty cool, sharpness rate, and fortune too. It's not the best fortune, but still fortune too. You can get yourself some pretty cool digs with that. If you go and get yourself, you know, enchant your diamond pickaxe, go around this mine or this world, and I'm sure you'll find lots and lots and lots of things to dig and get extra of. Obviously, diamonds being the main one there, or redstone. If you're a redstone guy like me, you might want to go and find as much redstone as possible. And the creeper is in the hole. Why are there so many creepers? I know the zombies, because we've got a zombie spawner, but still, creepers everywhere. I don't know why. Anyway, guys, that is it for this week's seed. There is also surface lava, so you want to go and get obsidian. You got your diamond, you got your diamond pickaxe now. Get yourself some obsidian. Go to the nether. You can go to the nether straight away. You've been on the server, on this world, even for maybe like, I don't know, what, 10 minutes? 10 minutes, you can go to the nether already. What more do you want from me? So anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed the seed. If you would like, share, comment, subscribe, tell your friends, tell your family, tell your goldfish, tell your next door neighbor's dog. Tell your next door neighbor before you tell the dog, because it's not very nice to tell a dog before you tell a human. I mean, tell your neighbors first. It's only fair. Anyway, guys, until next time, TTYL, peace out. Bye-bye. Can I ride you? I want to ride you. Let me ride you. He wants a hug? Hug me. Hug me, horse. This is just weird. It's a seahorse. And World Sea Sunday will be complete without the amplified section. The time of the video when I show you what the sea looks like in the amplified. That's the setting that we all love, but not many people can run. Now, as always, I give you a word that you can put in the comments below, so I know that you stay till after the credits. Now, if you watch my D&D stream, Dragonheart's D&D stream, which I'm a part of, you'll know that there is a new shipping going on between me, who I play Odo Saru, and Muffins, who plays Mungo. And the new shipping name is Mungodo. So, if you're a fan of that, and if you understand what I'm going on about, if you don't understand what I'm going on about, go and check the description. There is a link to the D&D stream. You can go and catch up on all of the Cityscapes D&D stream from their start till now. But yes, Mungodo is this week's word. So put Mungodo in the comments below, and I'll still know that you stayed till after the credits. Maybe you want to put the word Mungodo. Maybe you want to put a full story about Mungodo. Maybe you want to tell a love story between Mungo and Odo, and how they met, and what drove them to becoming the two people that they are today. Maybe you want to make me laugh with a funny little story. Nevertheless, put whatever you want in the comments below, as long as it contains the word Mungodo, and I will know that you stayed till after the credits. And you're one of my favorite subscribers, because you stay. You just don't come and get a seed and leave, you stay. Thank you. So, this week's seed, as I say, in Amplified, it looks like this. It is not as epic as I was expecting. Okay, maybe it is. So right behind where you spawn, there is this huge cliff. Now, the village was here. What happened to the village? What happened to the village? It was right there, and now it is, oh, there. Okay, so it's now in this little chasm of its own creation. So you got this, wow, that's like a really tall farm. That is an insanely tall farm. Holy crap. I just love the way that generation works. So you got some really tall farms going on. That is the funniest sight I've seen in a long time on Minecraft. Look at that. Know what would make it funnier? If there was a village or anything going, I don't know what to do, guys. I can't go home. So over here, we have a very tall house as well. Does it contain a villager who can't get out? Please say it does, please. Oh, it does. Oh, he can't leave. Sorry, dude. So yeah, as you can see, the village is still here. It's in its own little chasm. There, it's surrounded by walls to protect itself from the many, many mobs which are trying to kill it, I suppose. And of course, you've got the giant walls of awesome. Now over there, you've got some floating islands, and the desert, I don't know, the desert isn't as impressive as it usually is. Maybe it's because I'm not too far into it, but usually you see like the deserts and they're up to like 255 or 254 blocks high. This thing is pitiful in comparison to usual. So it might not be the greatest amplifier we've ever seen in the past, guys, but it is a pretty cool one nevertheless. You've got some lava falls going on, and it's not huge, but still, 208 is nothing to, you know, be shabby about. Well, 206 blocks high. Nothing to, oh, is there a high one there? No, that's not. So 206 blocks high, not the shabbiest of all mountains, but still not as cool as what we've seen in the past, I can guarantee you on that. But nevertheless, it is pretty cool. Now, as always, I find the highest point I can find, which is, I think, that block right over there. And I jump off it to my doom, to my death. And actually, is that higher? Oh, controversial. I think we have a higher point right there. Yes, it is higher. So we're going to go in Savannah. And it's actually pretty cool, nevertheless. So we're going to go in the Savannah here. And I want to make sure I've got like a large jump, because last time it was kind of pitiful as well. My jumps were just really bad. That one's quite low down. Wow, there's nothing that's got a long jump here. Right, I'm going to go from the second highest. This is, I think, is the second highest. So I'm going to build. Yeah, I'm going to do it from here this time. All right, so we're going to jump from this bit here. This tree to make it cool. So I'm going to go into game, game mode, survival. Put myself into F5 mode. There you go. Hi, guys. And until next time, TTYL, peace out. Bye-bye. Remember, guys, Mungodo! It's a beautiful relationship and a beautiful shipping. Ah, I didn't hit the ground. I hit the wall. Oh, well. Bye, guys. What a beautiful lava fall that is. So beautiful. Oh, it's been floating. It's a floating island of lava fall. Yay!